Welcome to the tutorial on General Approach to Combinational Logic Design. In this particular tutorial, we will try to obtain the synthesis of a combinational logic which starts with the problem statement and progresses through a series of steps which terminates in the final circuit design. Earlier, we have seen the problem statement to truth table block diagram, which has been presented here again. So you can see that in the block diagram, we have the problem statement, which is an important part of any digital design task. And once the problem statement is given, from this, we rewrite the problem in the form of a truth table, and from the truth table we obtain the switching equations and simplify the switching equations, and finally we obtain the logic diagram and we can build the logic circuit. So here we are presenting the design steps that we have already seen. And this is one of the general approaches to any combinational logic design. So as a first step, what we do is we develop a statement describing the problem that needs to be solved. Secondly, based on the problem statement, we construct a truth table that will clearly establish the relationship between the input and the output variables. In the third part, using the various simplifying methods that we have studied, that is the Karnaugh map or the Queen-McCluskey method, we simplify the functions and we obtain the required output and express them either in the form of an SOP, that is sum of products, or POS, that is product of sums. In the fourth step, we arrange the simplified equations in order to suit the logic primitive type to be used in realizing the circuit. Then we draw the logic diagram, and in the last step we document the design by identifying the variable names that indicate the different levels and if possible provide a truth table. So with some solved numericals, let us understand how these design steps are implemented. From the beginning of understanding the problem statement to obtaining the circuit diagram or the logic circuit. So here is the first numerical which says that we need to design a combinational logic circuit that will multiply two-bit binary values. Let the input variables be A and B of 2-bit. Then we have A1, A0, B1, B0. And in order to find out the number of output variables required, let me consider the maximum 2-bit number, which will be equal to 11 in binary and which is equal to 3 in decimal. So 3 into 3 will give me a result of 9 on multiplication, which is represented in binary as 1001. So that means I require 4 variables. So let me consider the output variables to be P3, P2, P1 and P0, with P3 being the MSB and P1 being the LSB. And similarly, I have A1 to be the MSB and B1 to be the MSB at the input side, and A0 and B0 will be the LSB for the corresponding A and B variables. So when I denote the truth table, I have A1, A0, B1, B0, and I have outputs P3, P2, P1 and so here I am going to denote the multiplication in terms of decimals. So you can see the one marked in green color. So the left corresponds to variable A and the right corresponds to variable B. So 0 into 0 will give me a result of 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 0 into 2, 0 into 3, 1 into 0, 1 into 1, 1 into 2 and so on. So I'm clearly highlighting the difference by marking it in yellow and green in terms of decimal numbers. And we can represent the output SOP equations, that is P3, P2, P1 and P0, where P3 is the MSB, P0 is the LSB bit. And we are going to write in the form of an SOP, that is the sum of product form. So you can see the expression for P3 is equal to A1, A0, B1, B0. P2 is equal to A1, A0 bar, B1 plus A1, B1, B0 bar. P1 is equal to A1 bar, A0, B1 plus A0, B1, B0 bar plus A1, B1 bar, B0 plus A1, A0 bar, B0. Whereas for P0, it will be equal to A0 into B0. And the min terms are highlighted in the green. So here we present the circuit diagram, and there are two ways of representing: one using the NOT gates and OR network, and then you have another representation on the right side wherein directly I have indicated the NOT gate in terms of A bar or B bar. So coming to the second example, which says we need to design a combinational circuit that will accept a 2421 BCD code and drive a TIL 3127 segment display. So since it is mentioned a BCD code, we know that BCD code will have decimal values from 0 to 9. And the TIL 312, that is a 7 segment display, is a common anode red light emitting diode display package. So here we are going to present the truth table showing the decimal notation for the BCD from 0 to 9 and the corresponding outputs, that is W, X, Y and Z. So the output is a 4 variable. So let us see how to obtain the output for the 7 segment display. So for that reason, I have presented the 7 segment display for the TIL 312, and you can see that they have total of 14 pins, and each alphabet, that is the 7 alphabets that are present in the 7 segment display, correspond to the cathode. So if you want to obtain the combinational logic output, we need to drive the cathode of the 7 LEDs in the display package, and the LED common anodes have to be connected to plus 5 volt DC supply. When the control signal connected to the corresponding cathode is logic 0, then that particular LED will be lit. So here we are presenting a truth table which shows the decimal notation of the BCD numbers from 0 to 9, and then we have the min and the max term decimal notation, the inputs W, X, Y and Z, that is the BCD inputs, and at the output side we have totally 7 LEDs, that is A, B, C, D, E, F and G. And these LEDs will glow only when they are provided with a logic 0. That means active low outputs will turn on each of the 7 segment LED. So that is why you can observe or compare this logic diagram with the previously shown 7 segment display, that if you want to obtain a 0, then G is supposed to be equal to logic 1. And if you want to obtain or display 1, then you need to have B and C to be logic 0, rest all of them should be high. So in a similar manner, it goes on for numbers from 2 to 9 also. Now these active low output functions can be expressed either as the max terms or the min terms. And looking at the truth table that is obtained here, we have the active low POS equations. So POS means we have to write the expression corresponding to the max terms. So I'm going to highlight all the zeros corresponding to the variable A. And I need to look at the term decimal, that is min max term decimal, and mark only those decimal values to be equal to 0 which are corresponding to the light pink color. Remaining variables will be don't care terms. So I have A is equal to pi m 0, 8, 9, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15, and remaining terms will be the don't care terms. So here I'm going to use a 4 variable kmap, that is because you can see that the numbers are ranging from 0 to 15. I'm going to place the don't care terms and the max terms and form different groups. I will always begin with the larger group of 4 max terms, and then I will obtain the simplified expression for A. In a similar manner, I can obtain the simplified expression for B. Again, I will obtain these decimal notations by comparing the truth table, and I have it as pi m to be equal to 0, 1, 8, 9, 10, 13, 14 and 15, and remaining are the don't care terms. So on mapping, I get the simplified expression to be equal to x plus y into x bar plus z bar into y bar plus z. So in a similar manner, I'm going to proceed with the variable C, D, E and F and G. from the Karnaugh map, we have obtained the active low POS equations. Now, if you want to find out the active low SOP equations, the same procedure has to be done. But in this case, we need to map the min terms. So I'm directly going to write the shorthand decimal notations for the min terms and the corresponding SOP equations. And these SOP equations I'm going to use in order to realize the circuit. For the realization purpose, we will use the NAND gates because it is more simpler to implement using the NAND gates when we are using the SOP equations. So whatever SOP equations that we have obtained previously, we are going to double complement them so that we can represent the expression in terms of NAND gates. So you can see that expression A is double complemented in order to obtain expression in the form of a NAND gate. So we are going to do the same thing for all the variables B, C, D, E, F, and G. One major observation that you can see is that for the implementation of the NOT gate, we have used the NAND gate itself, which is highlighted in the green, by shorting the inputs.